Στο Delphi Economic Forum συζητάμε με την κυρία Ντέμπορι Γουίν Σμιθ, είναι πρόεδρος και διευθύνουσα σύμβουλος του Αμερικανικού Συμβουλίου Ανταγωνιστικότητας. Thank you for being with us, Mrs. Γουίν Σμιθ.
So, nice
to see you too. First of all, your impression of your experience here in the Delphi Economic Forum. It's the first time that it's been held in Greece and by a Greek firm, a company as well.
Well, I think it's a very creative initiative, and it's an innovation to have the forum, and to bring it here to Delphi is really very strategic too, because of course this is a place where there was so much creativity, and the whole purpose of Delphi and the gathering really in many ways is symbolic about what we're trying to accomplish here at the forum.
We are talking about competitiveness, especially here in Greece, during all this period of the economic and debt crisis, and the thing is that it seems like Greek economy, it seems like we haven't done as much as we should do in order to bring back the competitiveness in the Greek economy. Have we run out of time or not?
I don't think you've run out of time, but I do think that it's really an imperative now for all parts of Greek society and business and the government to really come together now to develop a long-term strategy, and to do so in a way that's going to focus on your capacity inside this country to innovate and to grow and not rely so much on what's happening outside in terms of resolving the fiscal crisis, because that process is underway. What I'm concerned about is that there's not a accelerated movement on the structural reforms. Mm-hmm. And they're hard. You know, they're hard in any part of the world when they're undertaken. But, you know, I have a few suggestions about some of the things that need to be done. But if that doesn't happen, you know, the other things will get solved, but there still won't be the conditions for growth.
What kind of suggestions?
Well, one of the ones I think that's very important is over time, and this doesn't have to be overnight, but there has to be a process, the public sector has to be reduced in terms of the size it has, both in the economy and employment. And coupled to that, I think there really has to be a acceptance in Greek society to embrace the private sector and to give business the prestige and presence it needs in developing growth. Because at the end of the day, it's businesses that create wealth and jobs and innovate. And if you don't have, you know, that balance, there's too much reliance that the government's going to solve all the problems here. The private sector has to get moving in Greece.
Mm-hmm. Yes, but you say that the private sector has to get moving, but it's not the private sector the factor that is to blame about all this, because the society, a part of the society, lives in and acts via a conspiracy theory. On the other hand, the governments throughout all these 6 years of the crisis have done nothing in order to motivate people and to communicate them that, okay, the profit is not something that makes you feel guilty, but is something productive and is something healthy for the economy's growth.
Well, actually, you said better what I wanted to say, that there needs to be a collective restoration of an understanding of the proper role and necessity of a dynamic private sector. And there's so many things right now in the Greek society as well as in the economy where it's almost as if the private sector is like Gulliver in Gulliver's Travels, being held down. I said this earlier, you know, with all the ropes and everything that make it impossible to not just attract foreign investment from outside, but to marshal the existing resources to really invest and grow the economy. And of course, one of those things that's very, very deleterious is this Byzantine web of all the regulations and permitting and all the things that make it so difficult for businesses to operate. We saw from the World Bank report the number of regulations, you know, in other parts of Europe just to do an olive oil processing. Here, it's like 4 times the amount. So, you know, the regulatory impediment has to be addressed, and that's where the government has to take the initiative to start working on that. They can't wait any longer.
Thank you.